Hello students, welcome back to the biology class. So in the last class we continued the 22nd chapter, that is the chemical control and coordination, chemical coordination and integration, and we discussed about the pituitary gland in detail from the NCERT as well as from the notes. We learned in the last class that pituitary gland is the second gland present in the cranium. So it apart from the hypothalamus, there is pituitary and pineal. We learned in the last class that pineal gland is in link with the hypothalamus, and it acts under the command of hypothalamus as the master endocrine gland, or also called as hypophysis, also called as conductor of the endocrine symphony. We learned that as just like the hypothalamus develops from ectoderm, pituitary also develops from the ectoderm, and we learned that it lies in the cavity which is called as cella tarsica. This cavity is present in the sphenoid bone of the skull, and pituitary is linked with the inferior surface of hypothalamus with the help of the stalk called as infundibulum. We learned that all the hormones which are secreted from the pituitary are called as pituitrine. We learned in the last class that morphologically it has three portions, and those portions are the anterior lobe, intermediate lobe and posterior lobe, also called as pars distalis, pars media and pars nervosa. And functionally it is of two types. It has two portions, the adenohypophysis, which includes the anterior lobe and the intermediate lobe, and the second part is the neurohypophysis, which includes the posterior lobe only. We learned in the last class that these lobes carry various types of cells which are involved in the hormone secretion. We learned that from the anterior lobe and from the intermediate lobe, the hormones released are the trophic hormones, because they stimulate the other glands to function. So we learned that there are five types of hormone secreting glands in the anterior lobe, and they are somatotrophs, lectotrophs, thyrotrophs, corticotrophs and gonadotrophs. We learned that they are respectively responsible for formation of the and secretion of the human growth hormone. The lectotrophs responsible for the prolactin, responsible for the milk release, milk production. Then the thyrotrophs are involved with the thyroid stimulating hormone, and corticotrophs are involved with the adrenocorticotrophin hormone. We learned that the gonadotroph cells present in the anterior lobe of pituitary releases two types of hormones, which are called as follicle stimulating hormone, FSH, also called as the gametokinetic factor, and the second hormone is the luteinizing hormone, LH, which is also called in the case of male humans as interstitial cell stimulating hormone, or ICSH. We learned that the intermediate lobe releases only one hormone, and that is the melanocyte stimulating hormone, or MSH. We learned that this hormone is involved with the hair pigmentation as well as the skin hyperpigmentation, especially during the pregnancies. We learned that these two portions of the pituitary gland are under the hypophyseal portal system control. So whenever there is a releasing factor or inhibiting factor released from the hypothalamus, it causes the motivation of these hormones to be released or to be stopped. Now the next portion of the pituitary morphologically is the neurohypophysis. We learned in the last class that the neurohypophysis consists of only one lobe, that is the posterior lobe or the pars nervosa. And we learned that neurohypophysis is under the neural control, direct neural control of the hypothalamus. So the neurons which are present, which starts in the hypothalamus, they end with their axonal terminals in the neurohypophysis, and they release the hormones. So these hormones which are generally released, which we believe to be released from the neurohypophysis, are basically synthesized and passed out from the hypothalamus. So these two hormones are oxytocin, also called as the pitocin, which acts as a birth hormone, and milk ejection hormone, which is also a strong vasodilator as well as myoconstrictor. And the second hormone is the antidiuretic hormone, ADH, which is also called as vasopressin as well as pitresin. And this hormone is a myoconstrictor as well as a vasoconstrictor. So we learned about the diseases also associated in the last class with pituitary, that if there is over secretion and the under secretion, then disorders happen. For example, we learned that if there is hyposecretion of the growth hormone from pituitary gland, it causes from the childhood, it causes a disorder called as dwarfism. So under secretion of this growth hormone from pituitary from the birth time onwards is responsible for dwarfism, in which the person stays short in stature, generally just 3 feet or 3.5 feet altogether. And then if the same problem happens in an adult person, if there is under secretion, it leads to the problem called as the acromicria, in which the tips or the body extremities become small. So ears will grow small, chin will become smaller, the forehead will become smaller, and even the nose also. And in the same manner, if there is over secretion of these hormones from the birth time onwards, it leads to the overgrowth of a person, so gigantism, where they are basically more than 7 feet tall. And then if there is more over secretion in the adulthood, it leads to acromegaly, where the limbs, the extremities or the limbs of the body, the nose, chin, ear, they all will grow bigger in size. And we also learned about the drinker's disease, which happens because of the under secretion of ADH hormone. It is also called as the diabetes insipidus.